Let's grab another artifact. Do some cool stuff.
Let's get something else. What else do we want?
So, why did we grab the statue?
Because it's cool, Toffle.
Okay. Chaos wand.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Woo! Chaos wand. Right, chaos wand. Chaos wand.
I don't know what there is to hit, but I guess we're gonna find out.
Well, we'll find out. Maybe they'll turn over. Yeah, reanimation stuff. True.
Yeah.
Ooh. Sweet.
What do we have? A creature? Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And it's got haste. It can get in there straight away. All right.
Make a token.
I guess we just start proliferating a bunch.
Yeah.
All right. Sweet.
Sure, why not?
And that gives us enough to proliferate twice. Cool. All right.
Stump
Perfect.
It.
I love it.
We'll get there. Sooner or later, we'll get there.
Oh, the Llanowar Elves attack with haste.
Yeah. With Bond of Revival. That's what we came here to do. I mean, you may have won a Mythic Championship, Tuffle, but you definitely didn't cast Bond of Revival on a Llanowar Elves at any point during the weekend.
Or in my life.
Focus up, nerds. Welcome to a very special episode of The Arena Boys. It's time to enter the arena with me, Riley Knight, and joining me this week and every week, thankfully, it's Torolf Toffle Severin.
What?
And Yamin Kalf.
Hey, this is a great episode because we're going to cover a topic that, you know, many of you have probably already heard about because, you know, we've tweeted about it and we've discussed it in person. It was basically the talk of the weekend.
So let's sort of let them behind the curtain here a little bit. We actually recorded, because we were going to be busy with the Mythic Championship and a whole lot of other stuff like that, we knew we would struggle to get episodes in on time, so we actually recorded them ahead of time. So there were two episodes coming in the future that we recorded ages ago. But of course, after what happened this weekend, we were like, well, we have to push those back, and now we're doing this.
It would
because
be weird not to mention that, right?
Because, exactly.
Yeah. All right, let's not talk too much.
I
cashed the Grand Prix for $250.
That's what I was going to say. One of us had an incredible weekend and put on a performance at the Mythic Championship that everyone was just so impressed by. I really had one of the best weekends I've ever had on coverage, I think. So we really wanted to, what did you say, Yamin?
I don't know. I wanted to congratulate you, Riley, for having such a good weekend on coverage.
Yeah, and I wanted to say well done to you as well, because you cashed the GP, which is obviously a huge thing. And so we thought, you know, in light of that, we'd
do a special episode.
We'd have a special episode because, how was your weekend, Toffle? Did you do anything? You get up to anything? Or
I got pizza twice, like Saturday and Sunday.
You got pizza twice?
Yeah, like a very good pizza place.
So there's a highlight for you, was it? What kind of pizza was it? What was on the pizza?
What was on the pizza?
The pizza was really good, but I can't remember what exactly was on it.
I had like a cream cheese onion pizza.
Oh, that's very disgusting, mate. What's wrong with tomato sauce on your pizza?
I don't know. I like it creamy.
Okay. Oh, well. Anything else? Pizza was the highlight, was it?
I mean, you could also say there were some games of Magic.
Some games of Magic.
Yeah, you want a couple of games of Magic.
19
so I heard.
Rounds of Magic to be played for you, which is unusual for someone playing the Mythic Championship, because there's only 16 rounds of Swiss. And no, you did not win a trial or win your 8-man before your 8-player draft beforehand. Nope. All right.
We can dispense with the silliness for just a few moments. Oh my goodness me. Torolf Toffle Severin, what have you done?
Mythic champion.
Oh, excuse me. This is like a
Mythic
title.
Champion Severin.
This is now a title. Is it like Sir or Lord? Mythic champion Torolf Toffle Severin.
Seriously? We had to, like, on the way back to the airport, it was still not real. Like, the day after, it was still not real. It just doesn't feel real.
It's incredible. I've got two things to say. Firstly, congratulations. Amazing. What a performance. What a victory. Like, It just must be the most incredible thing, and I'm so proud of you. Secondly, what the hell, man? We've worked very hard to cultivate a brand here at Arena Boys that we're casual and laid back. We don't take magic too seriously. And then you go and win a bloody Mythic Championship? What were you thinking?
We have this huge distinguished, I don't know, like discrepancy. Is that a word in English?
Discrepancy, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Between fun and serious magic for winners.
Yeah.
And some are responsible for fun. for winners, and some are Jamin.
So what you're saying is you're the boring person on the Arena Boys, huh?
No.
But to be honest, like I think that's something that many people also discussed on Twitter or on Reddit or something, that Tuffle is one of the most likable Mythic champions there are.
Oh yeah, he's got them all fooled.
When you play Magic, Tuffle, your opponent will always feel like they're playing a good game of Magic, and everyone's having fun, and you just play Magic even at the most competitive stage, and it's always fun. I've never seen Tuffle tilt in my life, like really tilt or something, and I wish I had that ability. That's something I appreciate Tuffle for a lot.
All right. Well, before we get too into to the heartfelt,
let's stop that. That was way too much already.
This episode's going to be broadly similar to the rest of the ones. We got a deck we'll have a chat about in a second. But we'll talk about some of the feedback and some of the messages and what it's all meant to us, of course, throughout the episode as well, because there's a lot to get across. But let's introduce the deck that we're playing. It is Celebratory Mono Green Tron in Standard. What I've done is imported the deck that Tuffle played at the Mythic Championship into Arena, and this is what it spat out. We are playing Forest, which Tuffle, you played in Barcelona. We're playing Blast Zone.
Tuffle also played in Barcelona.
Which I have to say, one of the most important inclusions from all the cards from the new sets.
Yes, exactly. Yes, from all those cards that you could have
from all the two cards from the last 2 years or something.
But check this out, right? We've got one drops that create mana, which is the same as the other one. We've got two drops that search for land, right?
Mm-hmm.
We've got maps. Mm?
Well,
yeah,
very important.
We're going to be able to cast Khan on turn three, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Ugin's going to destroy a bunch of colored permanents for us, perhaps.
Yeah. We can also cast Ugin on turn three if we hit Llanowar Elves, Llanowar Elves, Llanowar Elves.
That's very true. We're going to be tapping our lands for more
do
than
that
one
with
mana.
The real deck.
So yeah, this is even better than Modern Tron. We've got a worm that gains life and then has a really powerful Leaves the Battlefield ability.
Basically Thrakdusk.
Yeah.
And then, of course, wrapping it all up with what this episode is all about. Because our little sweet boy Tuffle, he won a Mythic Championship and it's unbelievable. Couple more cards to have a look at in the sideboard here. We're playing Veil of Summer.
That's
of
a
course.
Modern all-star in the sideboard.
And we're playing also Leyline of the Void. And then a bunch of cool artifacts that we can fetch with Khan. In honor of Tuffle's win with Tron, we thought we'd play Tron. And in honor of, well, actually, someone sniffed it out. Soupcan Steffens on Twitter pointed out the fact that Tuffle's Mythic Championship win is the single most elaborate CFB commercial setup to date, and that they're ready for the payoff. So, Tuffle, in your own words, please give us the ad for ChannelFireball.com.
You know, there are strategy articles, and there are strategy articles, right?
Mm.
So, there are some articles where you say, like, okay, yeah, I kind of see what they're getting at, and there's like this mind-blown Mulligan decision, whatever's articles.
Mm-hmm.
And Channel Fireball is definitely the one from the second version, right? Best writers, except Friday, I have to say.
Some of the best writers in the world, for sure.
No, there's just the videos are great, the content is great, and apparently it leads to something good. There is value to be gained.
I mean, The thing about Tuffle's position now is that it doesn't matter if what he says is well-researched or well-reasoned or, you know, even true. He's a Mythic champion. Like, he can say whatever he wants.
I have a deja vu. I feel like this happens.
What do you mean?
That we have this... I don't know. I feel like if we said that before, it's like, imagine if you win, you can say whatever you want and it will always be true.
Yeah. And now
that does sound like something we would say on our show.
Yeah. And now you won. So now you can... The thing is, you've captured the minds and the hearts of millions around the world. So now more than ever, your brand potency is more powerful than ever before. So if you...
Yeah, and I would definitely just use it for good.
Okay.
I can only imagine that, yes.
Well, is there perhaps a message you'd like to give to our viewers right now, perhaps to use this power that you have for good? Maybe somewhere they could buy and sell their cards, perhaps.
Yes.
I'm so sorry, Soup Can Stevens. I mean, this was supposed to be the most elaborate setup for the CFB ad, but once again, it's all fallen apart. ChannelFireball.com, ladies and gentlemen. You know, at least begrudgingly endorsed by a mythic champion on this call.
No, but the credibility, of course, rises. I don't know if it works. If people want to believe me more, that's fine. I don't believe myself anymore. So I can.
I like that. I like that you haven't got an inflated opinion of yourself just because, you know, you've bested, you know, 500 people at the most competitive Magic tournament going around. Oh, well. Anyway, ChannelFireball.com, my friends. It doesn't matter the Toffle won a Mythic Championship or not. He's still telling you the truth when he says that ChannelFireball.com is the place to go and buy and sell your cards and access all sorts of free Magic strategy and a couple of rubbish articles written by yours truly as well. Let's get to it, boys.
You know, this definitely is more of a podcast episode than a gameplay episode.
I'd say so. Yeah, so for the people who, you know, complain about there being too much chat, not enough Magic... Probably want to skip this one, but then again, it's the first episode we've ever had with a Mythic champion on the, as on the team here, so you're going to be missing out on some red-hot serious Magic for winners. How about this for a turn 3 card?
Nice.
That was the turn 3 Ugin, right?
Turn 3 Ugin?
Yeah.
Just rip an Ugin off the top?
Just rip Ugin, and we got, at that point, we're better than modern Tron.
I mean, one of us is very, very good at ripping
ripping certain cards. How about you tell us about the top deck Ulamog?
What's the secret?
You know what my biggest problem is?
Game's too easy?
The game's too easy. Because it was pre-sideboarded, right?
Mm. Yeah.
So I had two Ulamogs in the deck, and I have no ability to find out which of the Ulamogs it was.
Oh, so you cannot like.
Oh, so now you can't like frame the lucky Ulamog.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right. But you know what I can do?
Frame
because I sideboarded out one Ulamog, I can definitely say which Ulamog didn't come in time in the third game.
Yeah, right. Oh, so you can put one in the shame.
That Ulamog, just one card too deep. Funny story. We were waiting behind the stage, right? Because friends are allowed to celebrate with you.
Hang on 1 second. What should I do here?
Just play whatever.
Make a person. Or just go upstairs. All right.
We have Tuffle on our team, so we're going to top deck perfectly anyways.
So, by the way, just before we go any further, I'm going to say one more thing. We're gonna do this show assuming you've watched and are on top of everything that happened over the weekend.
If not, you just found yourself 24 hours of content.
Yeah. Anyway, go on, Jamie.
Yeah, we were waiting behind the stage, right? Because you were allowed to celebrate with your friend if they win. Mm-hmm. And we were waiting behind the stage and it was looking great, right? Like, not great, but like it was looking winnable.
I had everything planned out. That was good.
Yeah, and then Toffle drew an Ancient Stirrings. And if that Ancient Stirrings finds something good...
Like any business spell, right?
No. It needed to find Ulamog because there were two threats on the board. Like that was the same situation as before.
Was okay
because,
I can't
because they had the Ravager and drew the land from the Ancient Stirrings.
Oh, that makes sense. Yeah,
yeah, Karn and stuff wouldn't be enough. That I needed the Ulamog again, which was so close.
Yeah, and then after the Ancient Stirrings
I had to take
you had to take the sphere, crack the sphere, and then find the Ulamog, but then you only had 9 mana.
Yeah, and then that was one of the funniest moments actually. I don't know if you see it, but in the second game, there was like this huge roar, right? I drew the Ulamog. Everybody was like, wow.
Yeah.
You can hear it from the casters. And then about 2 seconds later, you can hear it from the crowd. From
hey,
the
guys.
Area.
Guys, check this out.
Treasure map for zero. Nice.
Oh,
So good,
that
huh?
That was the cheapest map we ever played.
Yeah, it was pretty good. All right,
I mean,
stop
this
on...
map cost zero. Tuffle, how much did your maps cost over the weekend?
More than
they cost zero. One.
Yeah, mostly they cost one, sometimes two.
Anyway, go ahead. Sorry to interrupt.
Yeah, so of course my opponent was kind of realizing that the card I drew was kind of good. So in the third game, I drew the Ulamog and then they did the same thing.
Oh.
But I couldn't cast it because I only had 9 mana. And then I was like, wait for it. And then you can hear like, oh.
Yeah. Yeah, that was that was a real beat. You really really had us going there. One of my favorite moments was when we, because we all left. Obviously, we went out and back to the viewing area when you lost game three. And when Alvaro ooh. Was, oh yucko. When
that
Alvaro
didn't happen.
was trying to figure out the lethal attack, and obviously he could only get to 15 and not 16. Hauk was there, Christian Hauk was there going, no, it's not lethal. And other people going, no, it is. And no, it's not. And I was like, I don't care. We need to go because in case it's not lethal, we need to be there to lift him up in the air.
Yeah, I played Hardened Scales myself, right? And I'm not that bad with numbers as Twitter suggested. some people on Twitter suggested. So I was counting and I was fairly sure it was 15. But the way my opponent was like... kind of
they were behaving
moving they were so sure it was 16. I was like, I'm not sure what happens, I'm not blocking. And then well, it was 15, which hadn't like the play was the same, but like the outcome I was surprised. I was like, okay, let's see how that goes.
And what then, does plain white celebration do?
So it create it, you can do these four things as many times as we like. I feel like we
16 life.
I feel like we should probably get rid of this.
I'm pretty sure 16 life is the right play here.
Yeah, no, we can just proliferate three times and then destroy the Drake with... Wow, well, Toffle, you're going to make use of your...
We can... I mean, he is the mythic champion,
we
so...
we have to gain 16 life.
that's what you use the MC card on. We can also get this but back and cast it for four.
Oh, that's good.
I like that.
Sure.
Oh, no, but we can't get it back and cast it.
Why not?
We would have to take like a bazillion damage.
Why?
Because plain white celebration costs 7.
Yeah, but we're not casting this.
Well, why wouldn't we? Then how do we get it back?
With this?
Oh, from exile.
Yeah.
Yes, okay.
Yeah, okay. So, all right. Somehow I'm the one making the like the serious magic for winners decisions here. All right, bring this back. Go upstairs with Ugin. Cast another Ugin
for
4.
Tuffle is still like euphoric.
Yeah. So he's used up all of his serious magic for winners energy. He just wants to gain 16 life with plain white celebration. Okay, I'm done. All right. I think that's a reasonable turn.
Well, that was a good turn.
Yeah. One of our... I want to chat about some of the tweets and some of the messages we got. And I'll say this. We read... Well, I at least, and I'm sure the other boys did too, I read every single one of them. And thank you so much to everyone who came out in support of the Arena Boys, and of course, you know, Toffle as well. Having such a huge amount of support behind one of my best mates was a very special thing to you know, ride on the coattails of all weekend. But
also, thanks for all the one times we got.
Oh yes, like, we got a lot of one times.
There are 27 replies to that tweet, and I think most of them were one time.
Some of them were more than one time as well. April King gave us more than one time as well, which I thought
was... And Deutschmann gave us the onest time of all time.
Which is,
I mean...
pretty big. I'm going
to see. Do you want to know a fun fact?
Yeah.
I didn't use my one time.
Oh!
I mean, you had so many one times from everyone else, you didn't need to, right?
Yeah, I guess that's how it works, yeah. No. I should have used it for the Ulamog, but then again, it just came, right?
It just came without
the
one time.
But Zoe Suntimer or Suntimer pointed out, Toffle, I'm sorry, I think you used all of your one times, but I'm glad it was worth it. And I think that might be true. Should we cast Plain White Celebration here? What should we do?
I think we can just cast Karn and Minus to create a 4/4, right?
Yeah, that's
but I think we have to check in with our Mythic Champion here.
Champion, what do you want to do here, mate?
I agree.
Okay. Useful. Nice. Useful when you just get the carte blanche.
We could also have gained 16 life, you know, but
we're saving that. We'll gain the 16 life. Don't worry.
All right. If we're on tweets we liked, I have one.
Mm-hmm.
And it's actually from your mom, Riley.
This is very funny.
So you posted a picture of the draft table on the second pod, right?
Oh, yes. Yeah. This is at the beginning of day two. Yeah.
Yeah, and you said like, oh, look at our arena boys, 7-1. Yeah. And of course, I was drafting, so I didn't comment anything. And one of the comments from your mom was, don't be so naughty, Toffel. Riley's mom. Well, it's nice that she also signed
her tweets. Mom signs her tweets. That wasn't the... I'm just going to double block here.
Yes, yeah. Jump. Or double block.
Double block. One of the other tweets that mom tweeted at the end of the thing was, wonderful win, Toffel. Congratulations, Loretta. Now, obviously, she meant wonderful win, Toffel. Congratulations, signed Loretta, because she's an old person and thinks that you have to sign off all communications. But it does look like she's congratulating herself.
I don't know. Did you think it was a joke when I said that your mama told me everything I know?
I get no. She really. She's very wise, isn't she? She really has taught you a lot. All right, that is true.
Yeah. So I have no idea what I did wrong, and it kind of reminded me of my own mom when I was young. So.
All right, so
we can draw a card first.
All right.
I mean
it counts, right?
What I meant was activating the treasure.
Well, you gotta speak more specifically, don't you, buddy?
Should we do that now?
I think we just play Nissa
draw
and then
card.
Proliferate. That means
on
that...
On the token. Ooh.
Yeah, I like that.
I love it.
Yeah. All right. So Nissa. And then Khan's Bastion.
Oh, then we untap a land.
And then we can untap...
Wait, can we proliferate twice?
We can proliferate four times.
No, we can proliferate with Khan's Bastion.
Yeah,
but the question is we can't...
So what's this? We'll draw a card.
No, don't animate the treasure cove.
Why not? Because it'll die.
I don't know. I guess we can attack. Yeah, attacking's free. Attack Chandra.
Yeah.
But then they block. Is that fair?
That's fine.
Oh no, we can't proliferate twice. I'm dumb.
Okay, that's fine.
I'm very sorry.
It's fine.
Wait. Oh, I nearly unselected really the treasure map. This is very. You know what I'm really glad about though is it just hasn't changed the way we play Magic. You know what? You know, fame affects people in really strange ways. Like fame changes people a lot of the time, but not the Arena Boys. Not the Arena Boys. You know, we're always going to be playing dumb stuff.
Yeah. I somehow thought we could cast Plain White Celebrate or something. Like something went wrong.
Yeah, something went wrong somewhere.
No. I mean, now we're just doing it, right? Now we just proliferate four times or something?
But why would we do that now?
Because we can ultimate Nissa, can't we?
Yeah, that seems pretty good.
But, yeah. What is the ultimate? Eight?
Eight, yeah.
But then we have all these lands, but what do we do with the lands?
Yeah. I mean, we get all the lands. Isn't that cool?
I mean, it's cool.
I feel like we should animate some lands and then proliferate onto them.
A bunch of times on them.
What do we have in the exile? Nothing?
Ugin.
Ugin is nice to destroy Chandra.
Yeah. All right, let's start off with that.
Honestly, yes. Okay, so we get Ugin, destroy the Rotting Regisaur, then animate a land and hit Chandra, right?
Wait, yeah, what? They're like exiled.
Oh,
they don't have silver counters. Yeah, there was no way to tell that. All right. All right, so...
We can get the Ugin back with the celebration,
yeah,
right?
With the celebration, exactly. So Okay. Tap a land, then...
We animate first. No.
Oh, right.
Animate first with...
Because of proliferate, true.
Yeah, smart. All right.
I love that this episode, it doesn't matter if we commit mistakes, because...
Oh, I mean, we proved just... everything that, you know, we're out to prove, right?
Yeah.
That's the point. Like, whenever they say, like, oh, you did a mistake, like, but technically,
so
we could do
proliferate. Bring back a permanent and then just proliferate more, right?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
What could go wrong?
What could go wrong as we time out?
Oh, we have zero timeouts left. All right.
Oh, no! It discarded that to hand size.
Oh!
it
also,
got it
we didn't
back.
Proliferate, did we?
No, No, because it just automatically assumed we didn't want to proliferate. Well, that was a bit of a rubbish. That was a bit of a rubbish celebration, to be honest.
No. Yeah, that was.
That was a bit of a rubbish celebration. Sorry, Toph. We had this whole big celebration planned out for you, and then all of a sudden it just became all. Oh, mate. Sorry about that.
Wow. Perfect. More Jeez. Arena Boys gameplay.
And this is what I'm saying. You know, I really don't want to be one of those groups that fame turns into monsters.
No.
You need a lot of fame for that.
Proliferate.
At least we saw the line there.
Proliferate.
Okay, can I read the second tweet?
Yeah, go ahead. Another one.
All right. So after all of this, Schmutzli, I think we know Schmutzli, right?
Yeah, Schmutzli has been a long-time viewer of my now discontinued stream, but... Woo, Schmutzli!
I'm gonna jump.
Yeah. So Schmutzli said, you guys are gonna make even more fun of Jamin now, aren't you? And there's a very short answer that says yes. And there's a kind of elaborate, fancy answer that says, definitely yes.
Hey, yeah, so in short,
why would you make fun of me?
In short, yes. And in long, yes.
Yes.
I don't understand. Why would you being a mythic champion change the way, like, change the amount of fun you make of me?
No, it just changed the position. Like, do you want to suggest a play? It's wrong.
Yeah.
But, like, I'm not totally garbage. You know, like, honestly, many people have, like, the idea that we all just don't play competitive Magic, but, like, Riley has won an WMCQ at some point. I don't want to say that I, like, just Ultimate Nissa. What could go wrong?
What could go wrong, right?
I don't want to claim that I'm, like, a perfect Magic player, but, like, I know how to put down some cards at some, like... I have played the mocks and I finished fifth. Like, I'm not garbage.
No, that's very good. Very good.
It's really good, yeah. You really did.
We're very proud of you.
Yeah, we're very proud of you, mate. You did really well.
Ha ha, yes.
Oh, poor Jamin. He deserves so much better. All right.
I don't know. He has us. That's kind of good.
Yeah, maybe he's got exactly what he deserves, actually. Yeah. Man, this has been a marathon as well.
Yeah, but we do all this sweet stuff, and it's all, like, it's, we did a lot of mistakes, but it's sweet.
I would say this is probably the most characteristic and classic Arena Boys game anyone could ever hope to see. I think we just let Nissa die here. She's
block the 3-1.
Yeah,
block the 3-1.
Let's eat the shaman.
Yum yum. Oh, actually, yuck, covered in mushrooms. I don't like mushrooms.
We really needed a mountain and a banefire, or just a banefire. We have treasures.
Yeah, we don't need the mountain. I thought about that, but I thought, you know, in the spirit of mono green, we should keep things like that.
I can see you.
Let's grab another artifact. Let's do some cool stuff.
Let's get something else. What else do we want?
So, why did we grab the statue?
Like, because it's cool, Toffle.
Okay. Chaos Wand?
Yes.
Yeah.
Woo! Chaos Wand! Right, Chaos Wand!
I don't know what there is to hit, but I guess we're going to find out.
Well, we'll find out. Maybe they'll turn over. Yeah, reanimation stuff, true.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Sweet.
Do we have a creature? Oh, yes!
Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah! And it's got haste. It can get in there straight away. All right.
Make a token.
I guess we just start, proliferating a bunch.
Yeah.
All right. Sweet.
Sure, why not?
And that gives us enough to, proliferate twice. Cool. All right.
Stump it. Perfect.
I love it.
We'll get there. Sooner or later, we'll get there.
Oh, the Llanowar Elves attack with haste.
Yeah. With Bond of Revival. That's what we came here to do. I mean, you may have won a Mythic Championship, Tuffle, but you definitely didn't cast Bond of Revival on a Llanowar Elves at any point during the weekend.
In my life.
Oh, we got there, guys. Didn't put a foot wrong. Did not put a foot wrong. Wow. Just on that hot streak. Riding those coattails from Tuffle there.
While we're on the topic of the tweets discussing the events that happened, I really liked Simon Gertzen's one.
Oh yeah, yep.
Gonna start watching the Arena Boys to finally get better at Magic.
Oh, look, it's something that Simon's been needing to it's something he's needing to do for a long, long time as well.
Yeah, get better at Magic.
I mean, what's he ever done, Tuffle?
Well, he's certainly not a mythic champion.
He's certainly not a mythic champion, is he? No.
He's never won a mythic championship.
Never won a mythic championship.
I don't know. Does that get retconned?
It actually does get retconned. Yeah, I can give you the official inside scoop. So it means... So what happens is... So, for example, Andrew Ellenbogen won the very last Pro Tour, right?
Hmm.
So according to Wizards, he is a mythic champion. He won a mythic championship at Pro Tour, whatever it was. What was it? Pro Tour Ravnica Allegiance or whatever it was called. Yeah. So that's how it works. I mean, which is fine. It's continuity, right? Like it's kind of weird and grating for franchised and entrenched players now. But in 5 years, it'll make a lot more sense.
I'm sure in 5 years it will make sense. I mean, in the future, everything will make sense. You know, that's.
What do you want to do here? I want to cast Bond of Flourishing.
Play. Why not treasure map?
You can play treasure map.
What are you hoping?
I actually tried to put that back in the hand. I actually really tried to put that back in my hand. It was like, nope.
Ah.
All right. Well, no turn three Khan this time around. We don't have that Toffle luck this time.
Maybe we draw Simeon Spirit Guide.
Yeah. I don't even know. If that's even programmed into Arena, that would be very surprising. All right. Oh, and scribe that straight away for the immediate value. I don't want that.
It was... So, on day two, I was walking up to Riley and a fan of Riley's, right?
Yes. This is the best story to emerge from the entire weekend. This is so good.
So, I was walking up. And then I was greeting like, hi, and he says, yeah, blah, blah, blah.
So basically, someone had come up to me and was in the middle of getting my signature, basically,
a treasure map.
On a foil treasure map.
Yeah. So Riley was then, okay, I use your back to sign the thing. I was like, okay, sure.
So Toffle turned around and I signed, like I leant the card against his back to sign it.
And then we signed, we talked a little, and then Riley said, oh, okay, I actually have to go for coverage reasons and stuff. And the guy's, yeah, it was nice meeting you. And then Riley went away. And then the guy comes to me and is like, okay, great, I have one. Now I need to get one of the other two. And then just walks away.
It was so good. No, I hadn't left by that stage as well, because I was there like, oh, yeah, I have to get going. And then I was like, I guess, do you want the other Arena boys to sign it too? And he's like, yeah, I've got to go and find the other two now, with Toffle standing right there. It was it was so perfect. So good.
So that was Sam, right? Because I signed that foil treasure map too.
Yeah, you actually signed the map itself.
Yeah, I put myself on the map.
You put yourself on the map. Oh mate, you're all about that brand optimization. This is a bit of an issue. What are we gonna do here?
We could pump up the blast zone to make a token.
Make another token.
Yeah, we create another token, then both are 3/3.
And then we pump the blast zone to 3. I guess that's the best we can do.
All right.
Turns out mono green doesn't have a lot of removal.
So put 2 counters.
Yeah, you can just do that now.
Yeah, so Riley was walking away. He was walking away, and I was standing there. Cause I have a feeling I would see this guy again.
That was very good.
5 rounds later in the evening, he was like, I'm really sorry. But that was funny.
He probably has the very dubious honor of being the very last person, like, not to recognize you.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, mate. Come on. You are so determined to get you. Do you know what happened as well? So, obviously, Toffle missed his flight back to Berlin. And as it happened, me and Megan, my girlfriend, we decided to stay an extra day in Barcelona. Just to, you know, hang out, go and see the sights, that sort of stuff. So we met up with Toffle, a couple of his friends, when they were, you know, at their hotel. Anyway, we wanted to go and get some ramen. But the ramen place, the Spanish seemed to have very strict laws about when you can and cannot eat dinner. So the ramen place didn't open until 7, right? We got there at 6. And so we're like, oh, we can just wander around. And Toffle's like, well, let's go to some of the game stores nearby, so, because they're pretty good. And I'll tell you what, they really were. Some of the game stores in Barcelona seemed excellent. But Toffle
walked
in there.
Just to insert a little, like, those game stores look amazing.
Yeah, they seem really nice, right? And there's no joke at all. I don't know why you're saying no kidding. Like, there's no joking at all in this anecdote, because when we walked into these game shops, Toffle was then like, just walking around, seeing if people noticed him, wanting to check if... and then when people sort of ignoring him, he was like nudging me to say something about the... You know, because there was a modern tournament at one of them. And like, I don't know if one of the players was playing Tron or something, but he was kind of like, you know, going, oh, just saying, Mystic Championship, like this. And I was like, geez, all right, mate, settle down. You just won the thing. You don't have to rub it in people's faces.
You're the worst.
Sorry, what?
Wow, so Toffel is really just grabbing a lot of attention, or is trying to?
I mean,
to
and it's so. I mean, you know him really well. It's so such classic behavior from him, isn't it?
Yeah.
All right, before we time out again, what should we do with this turn?
Plus Karn.
Upstairs with Karn.
And then we have to get rid of the ram, right?
Probably, yeah.
Right. I mean, we're kind of very deadsies.
Yeah.
Yeah, kind of. But that doesn't really take away from the experience.
No, that's true. All right. So, oh man, that's okay.
So we can also play the treasure map to bump up our tokens to 4/4.
Okay. And then we need to play a land so we can kill that.
Yeah,
we can,
crack the...
I don't know. We're awesome. Not like just dead in the water, right?
No, we're really dead. Like.
Yeah.
Dead in the ocean.
Yeah.
I guess because every new land also makes another 2/2. We're just going to get buried in that.
Yeah. Next turn we can proliferate onto both treasure maps and flip one of them to like make our tokens really big.
Make it real sick plays, huh?
But we don't get rid of lots of tokens.
Next turn we can cast the celebration and concede.
Yeah.
That actually sounds like a very good play, right? Because that's what we're doing this video.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. All right.
Just celebrating. Sounds fair enough.
So what, gain 16 life, Toffel? Toffel mode?
Oh, honestly, we can't cast the celebration if we get rid of the ram.
Why?
Why not?
Because then we only have 5 mana.
Oh, we can't scry right now. Oh. So don't get rid of the ram.
Yeah, just double block it or something.
All right.
And then, if they attack with all...
Yeah, we just double block the ram and we live at 1.
Do we have any chance of removing...
the token?
All the zombies.
2 tokens? Yeah. Like, if they attack with everything but the 2 tokens, is there any chance we can remove it?
I don't think so.
No, because Ugin only does 1 permanent. I mean, this can block 4 of them, but...
No, like, if we could remove it, we actually might have a chance, but...
Nah. No, I don't think so.
Yeah, all right.
All right, so double block and cast the celebration, and then we're done celebrating.
All right, excellent. Again, plain white celebration has been a real stinker. Sorry, Toffel. All right, so...
Both of the tokens even die, which is really sad.
Yeah, it's pretty good, huh? All right, my turn. No scry. Didn't miss it. Don't worry about it. Gain 16. Toffel mode.
4 life.
Woo-hoo! Easy.
Dang.
Right, did it.
Woo-hoo! Nice.
Very good. A close one.
What is the celebration?
Well, it looks like Tron has a really bad scapeshift matchup.
It does.
Yeah, it does. And, like, you just don't interact.
Honestly, probably... Really... Sorry, go on, Dave.
I'm sorry, go. I like that everyone was spamming, like, Sears Magic for Winners under the official Magic tweets.
Oh, yeah.
Like...
Yeah, really, really
Wizards
good.
Tweeting something, like, very serious, like, Toffel.
Yeah.
Did this and that, and like he bested all of his opponents. Serious Magic for winner.
I can't believe the reach that we've obviously pulled together with this dumb video series. It is so amazing. It's incredible that so many people love to watch this silly
and
video.
Please keep doing it.
Obviously, I don't stop now.
That makes Magic fun.
Exactly right. We need more stuff like this, I think. But yeah, like, again, thank you so much. Oh my goodness.
Being in the finals of the Mythic Championship, and like everyone, I don't know, spamming serious magic.
Yeah, and talking about like
Toffel is the favorite arena boy.
That's
now.
Right. Like, talking about like the relative power rankings of the arena boys, you know, as was a legitimate part of the Magic discourse this weekend. It was quite incredible. upstairs, downstairs.
Which, by the way, is upstairs.
And there's still like a really hard contested discussion on who's second or third.
I'm obviously second. Third is the Ulamog that you top deck. And fourth is Riley.
Oh, get out of town.
I last heard.
Get out of town. I'm happy to put the Ulamog at third there. But I'm not. Come on, Jamin.
You're the fourth. honestly, I already got out of town. I'm now no longer in Barcelona.
I'm not happy with this.
Lucky
I'm not
you.
Happy with this. All right. Wow, what are we doing here?
What's the card exiled with Karn?
Let's have a look. This is Triumph.
That's not very good.
No, not very
good. I mean, we could just ramp twice. Isn't that fine?
This is Triumph doesn't ramp. You mean like Llanowar Elves plus Paradise Druid?
Yeah, and then we can cast Ugin next turn or something.
All right, let's
sure. Cast it.
I'm not
also,
I'm
I'd
not
like to tick Karn downstairs, like to create a token, I think.
I think so too.
Just to pressure the planeswalker while
makes
ramping.
It a little worse if they have like a
Clarion. But who plays Clarion?
Who plays Definitely Clarion these days?
Definitely not our opponent.
Bad against the field of Well, something didn't get better.
Hey, that joke was top tier.
Exactly.
Right, this is looking great. So we can clean up all these planeswalkers, can we not?
We create another token. Yes, we can. We just create another token with Karn. Then the first token attacks Teferi, and then Ugin gets to get rid of Napset.
No, because we can cast Treasure Map to...
What? Oh, for free? No, stop. The Treasure Map is free.
Hang on 1 second.
We
cast this.
Yes.
And then we can cast this. Cast Treasure Map, which pumps up the...
And then we attack Narset and ignore... We ignore Teferi for now.
You think so?
Yeah, and then we can deal with the next turn.
All right, so says the Mythic Champion. Do you know what... You know, Jamin, previously the line was...
I know Jamin, yes.
You know what we would always do? It's like when Toffel said something, we would do it because either he was right and we'd be closer to winning, or he was wrong and then we could say it was his fault, so we went either way.
Yeah.
Oh, yuck. That's not great.
Ouchie.
Now we can still destroy it. Like, it's fine. We can just easily rebuild.
Just eat up here. Yep. All right. So now what we can do instead is when Toffel's like, oh, do X, and then we do it, and then even when it has a bad result, he can then say, no, it was still correct. It's just that da-da-da-da-da, you know? And the impact of his words is so high. Do you know what I mean?
I really hope that never happens.
But the thing is, mate, like, all this power is just wasted on you, honestly. Like, oh, this is very good. You're in a position to, you know, heavily influence the Magic Discord and do things, perpetrate acts of great evil. And I know that you won't.
Which Magic Discord?
Discourse.
Discord. I'm sorry.
Got by my own witch joke, diss joke.
You know, I want to quote like a famous line from, like, I don't know, a high politician or somebody really famous. Mm.
Do you mean the famous quote, what?
with great power becomes great responsibility.
Ah, yes, the famous philosopher, Spider-Man's uncle. Yes, very wise words indeed. What have we got in exile here? Okay, this doesn't have a silver counter on it, and these do. All right.
So my strategy is, because I don't want great power, great responsibility, I just don't use the great power.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Very smart.
Oh, no. I guess go upstairs again.
We can create a token, I guess.
I want to get this Nissa out of exile next turn.
Okay, then go upstairs.
Yeah. We are playing a little scrappy today, so... The fans of serious
honestly,
magic.
We can reveal a big secret that has to do with said quote, Toffel. A few episodes ago, I made an impressive joke about Yarok. You know, the good old wordplay on Yarok and Yar okay.
Yeah, which went down amazingly well. I couldn't believe how you know what a positive response that joke got. To be honest,
and at this point, I'll admit it. It was Toffel's joke. Toffel came up with a joke. But before the episode, Toffel said, oh, no, it's fine. I don't want to make that joke. Jamin, you can take it.
Yeah.
So I took it. And that's kind of in the same vein, right? With great power comes great responsibility. And Toffel couldn't handle the responsibility that came with said joke.
Look, I really wanted to give you a break.
He really wanted to give him a little freebie.
Yeah. At one point, some of the viewers has to go like, wow, one time this was actually something reasonable.
That you want to give the viewers a reason to not wait. We can cast this. No, I don't. Do we want to sacrifice all the treasures to cast this?
No, that's not too bad.
You wanted to give the viewers actually like a reason to understand why we even have Jamin on the show.
Exactly.
Because obviously I provide all the hard hitting gameplay. Really you provide all the all the jokes, and Jamin is the
guy we know. That's what I read
in the previous intro.
Wow.
Yeah. The thing is, like with Jamin, like with a top five at the Mox, with a mythic champion, a literal mythic champion on the team as well. I'm now the guy that you two know.
That like was another tweet. It's not someone
great,
tweeted that.
Exactly. It's not a great feeling. It's really not a great feeling.
Yeah, and something else. I wish I could claim I was, you know, the arena boy who was at the Mox, but what few people know, back in like 2006 or something, Toffel played the Magic Online Championship.
11. Which, by the way, I also played in the Worlds because I came with it. So that meant I played 6 rounds of Worlds and then 4 rounds of Mox for 3 days.
Oh, wow. Sick.
So I played 10 rounds of Magic for 3 days and I barely missed top 8 for the Worlds.
You were pretty deep by the sound of things.
Yeah.
All right, what are we... Oops, that's not the Exile Zone. What have we got in Exile here? Another Khan. All right.
And it was amazing how like 10 rounds of Magic are incredible. Like if you ever played like a team GP where you have to play 9 rounds without buys, it's so draining. And then you play that 3 days in a row. it's very fun. Like, but at some point you just go very crazy.
Yeah. Let's proliferate.
Yeah, I think so too.
Woo!
Yes, that's perfect. Auto tapper getting things right.
Yeah, well done. I mean, with 21 basic forests, it's going to be difficult for it to mess it up, but I'm sure it'll find a way.
So we just get rid of everything, right?
How do we get rid of everything, though?
No, I guess we have to leave the fairy. No, I guess we leave Chandra.
All right.
Yeah, Teferi sounds a lot more scary than Chandra.
It does. Teferi sounds a lot more like scary than Chandra does.
What we could have done is we could have animated the Bastion instead. Oh, no, that doesn't work because we can't proliferate.
Oh, very smart. We could
have proliferated and then attack with Bastion and then proliferated.
Oh, jeez, that's why he's got...
That would have gotten rid of both things.
That's why he's the one with the trophy.
Bastion is... Probably.
Yeah, exposed to removal. Yeah.
That's why I didn't do it, of course. Nothing to do with the fact that I didn't see the line. What do you want to do with Khan again? Up?
Create a token.
Make a token.
As long as we have creatures, I just plus.
Yeah, that's what I think too.
Damn it.
You know I was going to agree with what he said. No matter what he said, I was going to agree with him. Yeah. Oh yeah, it's good because now. Yeah,
okay, I will adopt the line. Was like, I have something in mind, but Riley, I want you to maybe say.
No,
that.
No, that's not fair. I don't want to be put. I don't want to put the test like that. Right. Okay, revitalize. I'm not scared of that.
I didn't know revitalize was still being played.
Yeah, this is a very old school Jeskai list from like, geez, what, 9 months ago? Just updated with Chandra.
Yeah, who does that? Play like lists that could have been
It really irritates me. Like, play the new cards.
Yeah.
Like, play new cards. Come on.
Get yourself together.
Easy.
Be reasonable. Play some Holgak.
Easy game.
There was actually a major discussion about, we can't play a deck that doesn't play new cards.
They'll never feature us.
How do they sell the cards if they're not new, right?
One more?
One more.
Four more?
7 more. 19 more.
I mean, I got nowhere to be. I'm back home in Glasgow.
Yeah, I think we're all back home at this point.
Yes, indeed. So, a couple of things I want to cover before we close up shop today. I already mentioned it, I think, but it bears repeating. It's going to be a little confusing in the next 2 weeks because the next 2 episodes you're going to see... we recorded before the Mythic Championship, right? So they're going to be us in the past before, obviously, we knew that Toffel had won. It's going to be a really weird viewing experience because at one point we even joke about, like, oh, the Mythic Championship, look at all the things that we learned and all that sort of stuff, right? So that's gonna be a little confusing for people, I assume. Bond of Flourishing.
I kind of like Nissa's Triumph.
Yeah, I don't see what we want to have.
Yeah,
from
that's probably a good point. Right?
Like for example, now we don't want lands.
Right.
Do we take a land because the Nissa's thing might get countered?
So now we can do this. We can cast that. And hopefully
this
treats
us.
Hopefully this treats us a little bit better than your ancient starings.
More Karn.
Take a Karn. So yeah, that's just something to keep in mind in the coming weeks. But the other thing I wanted to talk about, we've already talked about this a little bit, is just how much it has meant to me and to Jamin and of course to Toffle, with just the incredible like reception or feedback or just the vibe, the presence that we got from viewers around the world. Like I've never felt more well supported throughout my Magic career as a broadcaster, as a content creator, as an entertainer than this weekend when I wasn't even the one in the spotlight and I still felt like I was being celebrated, which was just incredible. Like, just an incredible feeling.
Yeah, so honestly, like, Toffle receiving all the one times, you know, as jokey as it is, it shows that people support Toffle in a way that, like...
Like, having people like this at our back, it's just such a privilege. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, it is pretty incredible.
And, Toffle, I mean, you were pretty chilled out the entire weekend. You weren't too stressed out. You weren't too worried. You weren't too sort of, you know, highly strung or anything else like that. But, I mean, I've got to imagine, and if this isn't true, you've got to pretend it is, please, for the sake of our viewers. having so many people just, like, backing you up must have been huge.
It's... incredible that we as casual content creators, right? We're not tryharding. There are definitely people who work much harder and much more professional than we do, but with the easy thing of being who we are and just having fun, we enjoy and entertain so many people.
Yeah, that is,
and it's
truly something else.
The way of feedback we get is just all the things we really need for it. Like, there's nothing that I feel is more worth getting than just the enjoyment people have and the things they give.
It is just incredible. It's such a privilege to be able to be part of people's lives like this. So thank you so much to everyone for your support and for your silliness and for the teasing as well. It's such a, you know, it's huge. We really can't thank you enough.
I want to quote another great prophet.
Another famous philosopher?
Yeah, exactly. That's what I meant.
Can you help me through this turn first?
Attack Liliana with the vigilance.
Oh, this is vigilance.
Yes,
I never knew that.
We forgot about that in another video.
I never knew that. Look forward to me forgetting that in the next 2 weeks. Shall I go
then minus card?
Yeah, I got a thing out of here. I didn't include the Immortal Sun this time. You think so?
Yeah, we can just get Spyglass and name Liliana.
Oh, it's free.
Of course it is.
Very good. All right. Liliana. Dreadhorde General.
I guess Teferi just bounces Spyglass, but that's kind of fine.
Do we just name Teferi and then attack it? No.
Yeah. Actually, honestly, yeah, let's name Teferi because Thought Erasure is otherwise going to take it. Oh, but then we can Plain White Celebration it back. Yeah, name Liliana.
All right. We got answers for days. All right. And then I'll cast this, right?
Yeah.
Yep. So Toffle, hit us up with the latest philosophical quote.
So I'm not quite sure how it exactly went, but if I tell you what I mean, you know what it is. Friendship means being nasty to their face and being friendly behind their back.
Oh, it's very true.
And you know what? While Toffle was playing Magic, Riley still insulted him behind his back on coverage.
I always found ways to get the daggers in, man. I always found ways to get those daggers in. Don't even worry about it.
But that's the point, right? When I sit there and play, and I know you cover the match, I'm powerless. I have no influence on what you're
saying.
That
is not true at all. That is not true at all. You want to talk about being powerless? How about opening? How about owning the discourse when you open the thing? Okay. Welcome to this match, everyone. Big match ahead of us for this round here. It's going to be huge. We've got two superstars. Oh, okay. One of them's just put a card that says Riley sucks on the table. Now the entire round is about that.
Let's take another Karn card.
What do we got?
Let's grab another card.
Oh, right.
Of the
this Karn. Sorry, I wasn't sure which Karn you meant.
Probably even Chaos Statue.
Oh, Chaos One.
I kind of want.
No,
Chaos
but
one.
We can. No, no, we cannot cast things at instant speed right now.
Oh, right. Good point.
Oh,
great pickup, Jamin. Someone's getting some serious magic for winners in there.
Let's grab the statue. I really like the statue.
All right.
Make them pay.
Yeah, and it only costs 4 and stuff.
Maybe I should have played the new Ugin. Some list play it and
upstairs here. So
then we animate a land.
Made a forest. We can also cast this to proliferate like 1,000 times.
Yes.
Let's do that.
Do it.
Yeah. But attack first. Take down the.
Yeah. All right.
The Teferi.
All right. So do this. Oh, this got vigilance.
How useful.
I feel like I say that every week, but this deck, honestly, is just thrown together.
No, cast Karn first.
I was just checking. Yep. And then.
Yeah. What did you want to say, Toffel?
Just the whole list is thrown together randomly from what we felt like was close to the deck, and even that performs quite well.
The Arena Boys charm.
Yeah.
I want to give a little bit of credit actually to some of the people that because I did look up Mono Green. There was a list that was kind of similar to this one that was floating around back in May. The Asian Avenger was one of the people who was throwing around this list, and it was very, very cool. But yeah, I also just it was half that and then half trying to import Toffel's MC winning deck list into Arena. So we landed in a nice little middle ground there. Let's go get something else.
Let's grab another artifact.
Yeah.
I love it.
It's time for chaos.
Yes.
The problem is the most thing they have is probably just removal.
It's probably just creature
spin
removal.
The wheel.
Yeah, exactly. Ah, Thought Erasure, very good.
Oh, nice. Hello.
Ooh, even taking their acuity.
Oh, Devon's acuity. Ooh.
Yeah, we probably have to take Teferi because acuity costs 5 every time they cast it. That's not.
Can
like,
we? No, we have to take Nova.
We have
don't
to take
want
the. We have to take the cleansing.
Oh,
Nova,
true. True.
Yeah. Let them have Teferi. Let them eat Teferi.
Ooh, and this on top. I love that.
Nice, yes.
Okay, very good. All right.
Then activate Ugin.
Activate Ugin. Huge. Makes a 1-1.
Nice.
Makes a 2-2. Sorry.
This is the Arena Boys.
This is what we do, man. This is what we do. Get in there. Oh,
we have
dear.
To play now until we draw an Ugin from the top that is needed.
I'll choose forest.
Oh, perfect cards.
the finest forest. The finest forest. Oh dear.
In all honesty,
I had one of the best weekends of my entire life. I think
it was amazing.
I don't think that's a big call. That's not a Riley Knight's big call. That's a Riley Knight very small call. It was one of the best weekends of my entire life. To put things in perspective. I was on this week's episode of Limited Resources, the podcast that got me into Magic and is the reason that I'm sitting here doing this today, right? I featured on this week's episode.
Yeah.
And that's only in the top 3 of the things that happened to me this weekend. It was an incredible weekend. It was an incredible weekend, you know. And I wasn't even the one hoisting the trophy. I'm just so lucky to be, you know, best mates with the guy who did. And I'm so lucky as well to have such an incredible cohort of rabid, hungry fans at my back supporting me so well through this journey, through my career professionally and my the stuff I do personally as well. And I guess I'm friends with Yamin as well, which is fine too, I suppose.
Wow. You know, you say that like a joke and ha ha ha, teasing. I'm friends with Jamin, ha ha ha. But in all honesty, like this show is something that got created because the three of us were friends and this is what we did. Like there were long nights of us sitting on the couch playing Arena. No, actually not.
No, we never played. Arena wasn't out, man. We used to play Hearthstone.
No, yeah. We used to play Hearthstone. Ooh.
No. That episode hasn't come out yet.
Oh.
Wait, has it?
No, it does.
It's already out. Okay, no, it's already out. Yeah, okay, sure.
I don't know. We used to play Hearthstone, and we used to play Magic Online.
Mm-hmm.
Playing Wacky Brews.
Yep.
Wacky Decks. Just having fun. And that's like one of the things I think people need to know, that this is not scripted. This is not, oh, I'll tell this joke and then you laugh. And no, this is like us sitting down and recording.
It's actually just exactly what we used to do before I left Berlin. Like, Toffel and Yamin would come around every week and hang out at my place. We'd eat chicken nuggets and drink Pepsi and just have a good time. And then when I left Berlin and moved to Glasgow, we were like, well, we need a way to stay in touch. And this has been, it's obviously kept us together as friends, but like the fact that we now have sort of thousands of people in on all of our in-jokes and that sort of stuff, it's incredible. It's really cool.
And then the other thing that many people have realized with Toffel winning the Mythic Championship is that just because on this series we're not playing series Magic, but honestly, I'm sorry, just because we're not focusing to the fullest extent does not mean that like we can't play competitive Magic. These things are not exclusive. Like, you don't do one or the other. And I think Toffel's win has showcased that quite nicely.
Like, look, I play Tron.
Yes, I laughing the whole time.
Yeah, but yeah, I appreciate you saying like, oh, we couldn't play better, but it's really just Tron. Like,
he just refuses to take credit. He's one of the Mythic Champs. He refused to take any credit. No, it's just turn 3 con every time. So easy.
There was a situation where I considered playing blue white, but I just felt that at some moments I might not be as experienced to play the deck. Right, like this, it's not that bad to be not as good sometimes when you don't have the time or not the concentration. I mean, everybody who maybe streamed and recorded something, played and talked at the same time, it's very hard to play well and be entertaining and talk.
I mean, this is the other thing, right? It's like you say, you know, some people aren't that good and that's okay. This is the other, you've got to recognize your limits. You've got to know, I'm never going to win a Mythic Championship. I know that. I'm not a good Magic player. I've recognized that. I've hit my ceiling of how good I am at the game, and I just...
You bursted through this.
All right, mate. Thanks very much. But no, it reminds me actually, because, you know, I was scouring all the comments on Reddit as well. I never post on Reddit, but I've always read everything that's on the MTG subreddit. And in the thread that was congratulating Toffel on the win, someone asked, it was Iconic Isotope asked, can someone explain why lots of people are commenting Arena Boy? What does that mean? Toroff plays Arena a lot or something? And then Alas Babylon replied and said, Arena Boys is a series on Channel Fireball's YouTube channel of him and Yamin Kalf joining in commentary with Riley Knight playing on MTG Arena. Thus, the three are the Arena Boys. And then, okay, well, I regret having read out the usernames of these people, because the last one is to look for Troll. Looks like a procedurally generated password. Says, it's important to note that they play non-tier decks, and the focus of the series is humor rather than competitive strategy. Their motto, Serious Magic for Winners, is just a joke. Obviously not true. But it's clear that they're actually good players. And so I thought, you know what? Thanks so much for the vote of confidence, until I read the next sentence, which was, maybe not Riley, though. So thanks to Federal for that, you know, scathing but very, very accurate piece of feedback. But look, accept your limits. Know what they are. And, you know, as Toffel said, I mean, Toffel said this in his speech. Toffel said this when he tweeted about it. Magic is supposed to be fun. It's supposed to be a game, and it can be whatever you want it to be. And for us, it's hanging out every hour with each other, and also, as it happens, a couple of thousand people who watch it every week and just talking nonsense, having a good time. And it's such a humbling privilege to have people along with us for that journey.
Yeah, all right,
it's incredible.
That was beautiful.
Any closing remarks, Toffel? Any words of wisdom you want to impart to anyone? We haven't had an ounce of strategy content in this video, which I'm very, very proud of indeed. But is there anything else? Any closing remarks you want to make as a newly minted Mythic champion?
As if that gives more power. Like, I feel like people just give too much attention to like those things. Like, would have been any other person, would that be more or less valuable? No, if you feel like a person says something you agree with, then you should just like trust them. And if you like the person, you should just feel what they say, you know?
Do you mean the accomplishment doesn't change who you are as a person?
It's a classic Tuffle. I mean, without a shred of an irony, this is just classic Tuffle. I mean, I'm not like, if something like this happened to me, it'd go to my head straight away. I'd be strutting around like the cock of the walk. I wouldn't be able. No, I know this. It's a deep seated character flaw of mine. I love being in the spotlight. And I feel
like you got the occupation.
It's absolutely perfect, isn't it? But for Tuffle to stand here and say like, oh no, just because I've won this tournament, it doesn't make my view any more valid. It's, I don't know, man. It sums you up so succinctly.
I mean, it kind of statistically says something at least. It's pretty hard to win without being good. But there's such a small barrier between being good and actually being successful because Magic has so much randomness, right?
All right, mate. Well, at least, look, give yourself a pat on the back because you've done something amazing. So, you know, and if you won't, we will. I'm without a shred of irony, and you're not going to hear this too very, you know, very often on this series. We'll get back to the proper teasing before very much longer. But, mate, I'm so proud of you. Like, it's an incredible achievement, mate. So, you know, well done.
Thanks.
All right, dear viewer, if you have made it through all this rambling, we're proud of you too.
Yeah, I mean... you've also achieved something incredible today.
This is like the Planet Chaos episode of Arena Boys.
It is a little bit, yeah. Look, so again, we'll wrap things up. But again, just to make a couple of things very clear, next two episodes are going to be a little weird because they were recorded before the Mythic Championship. Just to make that, you know, that's the third time I've said that. The other thing is, nothing's going to change, right? We're still the Arena Boys, still going to be dumb stuff, still going to be good fun, serious Magic for winners, all that sort of stuff. And I don't think it would be possible for fame to go to Tuffle's head, but I can assure you it's not going to happen this time around. That is going to do it for this week at the Arena Boys. Thanks so much for hanging out with us. So you say it's not scripted, Jamin. This is basically scripted. I don't even think about it. I just spout it off. If you want to get in touch with us on Twitter, please do. Send in lists, of course. There'll be a little delay in us getting to any of them, of course, because of the two-week thing. But, you know, we'll get on top of it. At Rolly Query Tower for me, if you want to send them in, you can also DM me there like that. And if you want to join the new hordes of Twitter followers that Tuffle has.
At TuffleMTG. I mean, I don't write much, but that also, like, kind of... tripled my
phone. Yeah, yeah. He literally said to me over the weekend, oh, yeah, Jamin, he probably said the same thing you said. Yeah, good.
No, like on the walk outside the building with Arne, Arne checked Tuffle's Twitter for followers.
Yeah.
And he saw that Tuffle's last tweet was a retweet of Arne's stream like 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yep. Tuffle literally said to me, he's like, I've got all these new Twitter followers. I don't think any of them realize they're completely wasting their time. anyway, that you won't be wasting your time if you follow Yamin on Twitter. Yamin?
Yeah, I'm at Jackomattress, and you'll see the hottest takes. I posted some very relevant photos from Barcelona because I found a picture that said Lady Tron.
Oh, that was a good one. Yeah.
No other terrible jokes.
I had a good giggle at that one.
I have to say, like, objectively, one time I was Jamin might not be the funniest person on Arena Boy, but his Twitter is very funny.
Wow. I'll take that.
Yeah, that's high praise. That's from a Mythic Champion as well. Don't forget about that.
Oh, Jesus. His opinion is much more valid than any other.
It's much more valid. Exactly. you can also follow the show. Please do. It's great that we've again picked up so many new followers and so much new support. And look, if this is your first time watching the Arena Boys, welcome. It's so good to have you. Thanks for joining us this week. And I hope you go back through and watch all the other episodes and get an idea of what we're about. And we're back next week with good old fashioned nonsense. Blissfully unaware of what's in waiting for us, you know, a week or so after we recorded that episode. But that's that for this week. Thanks for hanging out with us. We'll see you next week for more silly nonsense. Until then, it is time to exit the arena.
Boys.